Hey all, it's me and this is my channel K&M Space HS. I will be discussing about aquascaping in detail, the method of aquascaping, different style of aquascaping, about basic aquascaping principles and even the key elements to consider. But before I move on, don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Also, press the bell icon so that you may get the further updates. So without further delay, let's just begin. The term aquascaping has been derived from the word landscape. It's the art of arranging aquatic plants along with rocks, stones, driftwood in an aesthetically pleasing manner within the aquarium. So you can say it's basically underwater gardening. Originated in the natural aquarium, a style that was founded several years ago by the Japanese aquarium designer and photographer Takashi Amano. He presented a totally new way of arranging plants and hardscape in a tank. Aquascaping mainly has three types. They all have different approaches and styles. The Dutch aquarium is one of the oldest aquascaping styles. It focuses on the arrangement and growth of aquatic plants. It does not involve any kind of driftwood or hardscape. You can use plenty of plants of different variety and colors to make your tank look more pleasing. The second aquascaping style is called the Iwagumi Japanese Zen style. It's the Japanese word that means rock formation. This style involves the arrangement of rocks. Only low-growing plants or carpet plants are to be used. This style of aquarium usually consists of a big stone and the other small stones in particular. Nature aquarium is the combination of the Dutch style and the Iwagumi Japanese Zen style. It includes the hardscape as well as the plants. It resembles a landscape or an image from the natural world, like the rainfall, forests, mountains, hills, valleys, and many more. There are a few basic aquascaping principles that you need to keep in mind when you start aquascaping. Number one is simplicity. It means that you should get less elements in your tank. Do not add too much. Number second is variety. That not just one plant, but you add a variety of plants. Number third is proportion. You must maintain harmony in your tank. Leave spaces and do not make your tank look congested. The last one is persistence, which is the most important one among all. Be ready to deconstruct or reconstruct. You must remain patient because it takes time for your plants to grow. There are a few key elements that you need to keep in mind if you're getting started with aquascaping. Hardscape materials are one of the key elements of aquascaping. They ensure the design and layout part of the entire aquascaping process. You can add hardscape like rocks, wood, driftwood, or even cosmetic sand to make your aquarium look astounding. A substrate is the surface on which an organism lives or grows and receives nourishment. There are a variety of aquarium substrates available, like gravel, sand, aqua soil, and many more. On the other hand, there are some plants that do not need a substrate. So do get to know your plant before you aquascape. Filter. It helps to filter excess food, fish waste, removes dangerous chemicals and bacteria. The growth and health of your plants depends upon light. However, if you are maintaining a low tack tank, then even the low voltage light will work as well. Carbon dioxide, which is CO2, has become nowadays an essential part of the aquarium. Most of the aquascapers use carbon dioxide for their plants to grow healthy and rapidly. It's costly but has been considered as a key element for aquascaping. Plants also need nutrients, vitamins, and minerals like we do. So if you can afford and want to see your plants growing and flourishing in the long run, then you need to have a fertilizer for your aquascaping tank. When designing an eye-catching aquascape, you must know which plants to use in your tank. Aquarium plants have got a great variety. There are carpeting plants and mosses, floating plants, then we have stem plants and epiphyte plants. These plants have been further divided into foreground, midground, and background categories. So before you get started, do keep in mind all the necessary details of your plant. Choosing the right fish for your aquascaping tank is a must. Select a fish which is delicate and small in size. Study the behavior of the fish before adding it in your aquarium. Some of the most common fish that the aquascapers select are neon tetras, guppies, cardinal tetra, barbs, and many more. Shrimps are great to keep as they remove algae from the plants and from your aquarium. They also keep your tanks clean by removing the food waste. You can also add snails for the same purpose. That was all about the basics of aquascaping. And for people who are interested in this hobby, as Balas from Green Aqua says, welcome to the world of aquascaping.